Hello, I'm Graham. Hope everyone is having a great day. This is the second video in this series where I will be explaining the shooting modes of Sony's HX9v compact digital camera. Today I will be taking a further look at the P or programmed auto mode. In this mode you have some control of the automatic exposure determination by the camera and thus the quality of the final image produced. The P mode is selected by turning the selector dial to the P position. In this mode of exposure, the camera is not influenced by any scene type determination. The exposure is determined by analysing the light levels reaching the imaging sensor from the lens. Depending upon which mode of metering is selected in the setup menu, will determine which parts of the image are used in the calculation. The metering mode most suited to everyday photography is the multi-mode, where all of the image is used in determining the exposure. There are some situations, however, like on a beach or snow, where using multi-mode will lead the image to being underexposed, and as a result it will appear dark. This is because the lighter areas are biasing the exposure. In this situation, it is better to switch to a metering mode, which concentrates on the central area of the image for exposure determination. This mode is called center-weighted. If the subject is small and the background is lighter or darker than it, again the camera will under or overexpose the image. In this situation, it is better to select a metering mode which concentrates on just a very small central area. This we call spot metering. By far the most useful feature of the P mode is the ability to be able to alter the basic parameters used by the camera, such as ISO, which is basically the sensitivity of the system, the colour mode, and the fine control of colour saturation, contrast and image sharpness. We should always try to keep the ISO set to the lowest possible value in order that we keep the image noise levels to the minimum, we have the best possible resolution and contrast. Try never to go above ISO 400, as beyond 400 the colour saturation and image noise will mean poorer quality images. From the main menu, you can select the main colour mode. The most three useful are the standard mode, vivid mode, and realistic mode. The amount of additional adjustment to saturation, contrast, and sharpness can be either positive or negative, and gives us the option to create an individual colour profile for use in a variety of situations. For example, we could reduce sharpness if you wanted to take a female portrait, or increase it if you wanted to shoot a gritty male portrait. If when we've taken an exposure using the P mode, the resulting image is too light or too dark, we can adjust the way the camera treats this image by making changes to the EV control and then reshooting. Going minus makes the scene darker and going plus makes the scene lighter. I now include some images taken in the P mode. The first image is taken in the standard setup conditions without any adjustment. In the second image, I've increased either the saturation, the sharpness, or the contrast, just to show you what the camera is capable of doing. On really dull days, you might want to consider increasing both saturation and contrast to try and lift the final image. And finally, a series of images just shot in the P mode, just to demonstrate the capabilities of the camera. Well, that's it for this video. In the next video I shall be looking at the manual controls this camera has, that's the manual focus and the manual exposure controls. Well, this is Graham saying thanks for watching, and as usual please rate, comment and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.